Hey, what is going on, y'all? I am back on the river today here in Minnesota, and I have finally made it back to one of my favorite stretches on the river. Not because of choice, but because of water has been up and ridiculous this spring. We've had so much rain, and this stretch of the river is actually capped out at around 18,000 CFS. And for me, 13,000 is unsafe and unenjoyable. So I've been waiting for those numbers to dip to around that 10,000 mark. We're finally here. So I'm excited to get back out here, chase some smallies on this stretch, see what's changed. Hopefully some smallies are in their same spots as I normally find them in years past. I do have with me a cool bait that I'm interested to try out. It's new for me, and this is the Fish Lab BBZ Bio Shad Gizzard. It's in that golden shiner color. It is a 6-inch, 2-ounce swim bait. It's a 4-piece, so hard body. Interested to get this thing out in front of smallies, see if it's smallie approved. I'll let you know, guys, what I think throughout the video, of course. And let's get this thing tied on, start slinging around, see if we can find some smallies. See you guys in a bit. All right, got a lay down right here. Let's hit up that front side. Chasing some minnows out there. So sick. That was a nice little smallie. It's probably like a 16-incher. It came up from behind us, maybe like a 10-incher that was stalking it. Then that smallie just came out. Oh, I thought I had him. I was just kind of bouncing him, jigging him along the outside of that lay down right there. Didn't get hooks in him. I'll do a few casts upwards, and then I'll try to do maybe a similar technique next to that lay down. Don't know how well you could see that. It's pretty dark, but I was able to see him come up on it. Sounds like we got some sirens going on in the background. That kind of ruins the mood. Get up there too far, but I'll try to get as close cast as I can up there. Oh, there's a fish. There's a smallie. Let's back up. Not a big one, but he went after it. Oh, lost him. That stinks. Get another cast up there. See if he's got any friends. That might have been the first one, actually, that I tried to get. Wouldn't bite. There's definitely some more up there. I know there are. That seemed to me like a reaction strike, so maybe I can get some competition brewing. Something big just jumped right behind me. I don't know what that was. Oh, so smallie. Smallie went after it. Come on. Come back. There was a smallie. Oh, there was a smallie that went after it. And I was jerking it like that. Bring another cast around here. There's a smallie. There it is. It tried. Got him. Oh, that was a good smallie. I was working on that guy. That was a pretty coolie. That's a good fish too. Let's get him in quickly. Get him in the net. Oh, that was an epic eat. Just dangling him right next to that lay down. Oh, that was pretty cool. All right, check out that smallie on the BBZ Bioshad gizzard right there. Not a very thick fish, but that is a cool eat right there. Try to punch these hooks out real quick and get them back on his way. Maybe we'll get the bump out. Let's see what this guy's coming in at. All right. It's actually longer than he looks. 17 3/4. But nice smallie. Let's get him back on his way. There he goes. There's a fish. There's a smallie. Oh, that's a nice smallie. Another good fish on the day. Swim bait is producing. Came out from that lay down, I think, right there with that overhang creating that shade. Get over here, get in the calm water, take a look at him. Another fired up fish on the day. See if he wants to get in the net. Oh yeah, good fish. Doing some gnarly head shakes in there. Pop that one out, pop that second one out. All right, let's take a look at this guy. That's a good smallmouth right there. Get this one on the bump. That beautiful fish. I'll set him back, get that bump out. All right, let's grab that bump. Let's check out this guy. If I can grab him. There we go. All right. Fish is on the bump. Oh, hold on, buddy. He is still fired up. Got him. Looked like he was right at 19 inches right there. That is a good fish. He's still got some kick in him. I'm gonna get him in the water. That's where he wants to go. So check out that fish one more time. That is a good solid smallie on the day, right at 19. Cool fish, cool bite. All right, buddy, off you go. There he goes. Got me wrapped up in here pretty good, but get this guy out. Back in the water, start throwing around for some smallies. Cool bite so far today. So far, so good. I'm pretty impressed with this bait, producing some nice fish. There it is. All right. Got another lay down and then a little slack water right behind this lay down. There's gotta be a fish or two hanging out in this spot right here. Try not to mess it up. Get as many good casts over here as we can. It's pretty shallow, shallower than I thought it was gonna be. Here's our shot, just don't get all the grass on it. Just do a steady, slow retrieve. I got grass on it. It's all right. That's all right. We're gonna drop one on the backside, right here. Oh yeah. Of course there's grass. All right. Struggling here, guys. get a bomb cast down there, and I'll turn around here and see what I can. Oh, that was an instant hit. That was an instant hit. Haven't had a lot of reaction strikes like that up against the bank, but that smallie wanted it. I think there might be another one with them. There is another one. There is another one. I'm trying to grip it out of its mouth. I'm gonna have to do something here. Let's hit the brakes, hit reverse. Go back up in here. Take a look at this killer smallie. Alright, let's get in there. A little bit of an awkward finish to the catch, but didn't want to slam into that tree right there, so we had to do what we had to do. Alright. Let's take a look at that smallie right there. That is a beautiful fish. Check him out. Probably another 16-inch-ish fish. We'll put him over right here. That was the first really hardcore reaction strike I've got today from a smallie. Most of them had been coaxed in, but that one just slammed it. Beat me to the punch. Fish was on there before I even realized it. So there was another fish that was just trailing him. I was really hoping to take a swing at the other hook that wasn't in the fish, but I couldn't get it to go. Kind of got caught in a bad position, so I had to focus on that. Swing in right here. We got a little creek coming in. Lay down right there. I mean, ambush city right here. All right. Start on the outside first. And then we'll bring it in inside. Try not to make too much room. Too much noise. There's one. There's a fish. Smallie on the outside. It's a good smallie. Trying to head shake it. Get in there. Yeah, it's a good fish. All right. Let's check that smallie out. That is a good, solid fish right there. Look at that thing in the light. That is a beautiful smallie. Put him back, get the bump out. Just saw a smallie blow up down there. My guess is this one's around 17 inches. Let's see. Yeah, over 17, almost 18, 17, 3/4. One more look at that fish before I put him back. That is a good, healthy smallie right there. There he goes.
All right, y'all, thought I'd do a quick mid-vid update on the lure that I'm using. Again, this is the Fish Lab BBZ BioShad Gizzard. It's 6 inches, 2 ounces in weight. And as I said earlier in the intro, it's multi-jointed, so it's got a lot of flexibility and movement right there. My initial thoughts is I'm pretty impressed by it. I think it looks really good in the water. When it catches the light on its side, when you give it some jerks, it lights it up. So that's pretty cool. Everything's stayed together so far. Like, it's held up. I've had multiple pike, smallies. I've got caught on rocks, stumps, all that. So far, so good. I will say the hooks are probably, like most treble hooks, they always like to get caught in things. Seems to happen a lot. That back treble hook wants to get caught in that back joint and around that tail right there. I've had to keep an eye on that before every cast. If you throw it out there and it hooks, it does have kind of an awkward tail action. I think I've had multiple fish hit this with the hook back there, haven't been able to get any hookup ratios. The other thing, the hooks, like the whopper ploppers and all that stuff too, they also are perfect length to interconnect right there. So that kind of sucks. Sometimes you'll get some foul hooks and you end up just pulling it through the water. It doesn't really glide for me when I give it big jerks. I was hoping to get, you know, some side to side on those jerks. It's more of like a side type deal. I have had some fish hit. I had smallies and pike hit those when I've been like kind of rapidly jerking it through the water. I would definitely have rather had some type of big or even really tight turns rather than that kind of flutter type deal through the water. So yeah, so overall, pretty impressed by it. First time I've ever used it. Definitely don't know everything about it, but got a lot to learn. So I'm gonna keep tying it on, get it out here, sling it around, see if I can find some smallies, and see if I can keep learning a few things about this bait.
That was a sick hit. It's a good smallie. It's coming up. Oh my god. Oh my god. That was a giant smallie. Oh, that was a giant smallie I just lost. Oh. He was trying to run up with it that entire time. Oh my gosh, that was a giant, that was a tank. Oh, that was almost another instantaneous hit. Oh, oofta. There's a smallie. Oh, he's going crazy. Not a bad one. Try to make a U-turn right here. Post up, get out of this current, take a look at this fella. That was just on a steady retrieve right there. Came out of there. Got it, let's drop the anchor right here. Swing them around, take a look at them. Oh, geez. Got an extra boost of energy right there.
Smallies always know how to get those other sets of treble hooks in. There we go, got those out. One, he has got a lot of energy. One last look at him. Kind of got a little goofy eye. I don't know if he's blind or what's going on in that right eye, but a little cloudy. I'm gonna get him back here.
He should be ready to go on his way. There he goes.